My name is Shaun Attwood. I was sentenced to 9.5 years in Phoenix, Arizona for distributing ecstasy. I went out to America as a young person. I thought drugs were glamorous. I'd never get caught. My parents would never find out. On May 16, 2002, a SWAT team smashed my door down and I ended up in the jail that's got the highest rate of death in America. Everything you take for granted in your everyday life is completely out the window. I had to get used to the sounds of heads getting bashed against toilets, bodies getting carried out on stretchers, people who looked like they were dead. I missed out on my sister's wedding. I missed out on my grandmother's funeral. I lost almost 6 years of my life. All my money was seized, so I ended up back on the dole, living with my parents. Couldn't get a proper job from a firm because it pops right up that I've got a criminal record at the job interview process. There's also certain countries I can never travel to. Just a couple of weeks ago, I stayed at my parents' house and I can still see the hurt and pain on their faces that I've caused them. I want to take that hurt and pain off their faces, but I can't. It makes me sick to my stomach. I've got to live with that for the rest of my life.
I'm Billy Reed, father of Melissa Reed, who is currently serving a sentence of 6 years and 8 months in prison in Peru for being convicted of drug smuggling. It's had a tremendous impact on us both emotionally and financially. It's horrendous to see your daughter in handcuffs and the living conditions that she has to put up with. Melissa has spent her own 20th and 21st birthdays in prison in Peru. She missed the significant event of her only brother's wedding. Events such as Christmas are non-existent for us. There'll be no celebrations in our house. There'll be no Christmas tree until we get her back home.
My name's Sylvia Riley, and I've got a daughter who was in prison in America for having drugs in her house, and she received a 7-year sentence. When I first found out, I ended up getting pneumonia, and I was unconscious for 4 days, and I had a frontal lobe brain injury, which caused me to lose my job. I know she's suffering, but it's how it's affected her family, everybody who loves her, are hurting because of what's happened. And when they do these silly things abroad, like moving drugs across, they must remember that they've got the parents to think of and the families as well, because she'll do the sentence with them.